There are very few people in Norway who could say that they opened the world's northernmost Chinatown in the same breath as a solo show titled The Richest Man in Gaza to doing a commission for Munch. Ah, here she is. We start with an introduction. Take a breath. This is going to be a relaxed interview.
Hi, my name is Helle Siljeholm and I'm an artist.
Helle is one of those incredible artists who's trained in both dance and the visual arts. In fact, she was told she was
too happy to be in visual arts school.
Helle was born in the north of Norway before her family moved to Tønsberg, where she grew up. She now lives in Oslo and travels the world, even through her artworks. We are now in her studio.
So I had a very different experience coming from dance and also theatre to the visual art way of using studio space, which is the atelier space. So I think I very much liked that way of that the studio space is actually very close to your home in a way.
This is how she works.
I'm very inspired by different people and different contexts, and I think this is maybe what I bring with me into my work.
Which aims to investigate and create connections between various contexts and perspectives. An urgency fostered in part through years of collaborative work in Palestine, Jordan and Lebanon. Her work has been described as
poetic and generous, but also really stupid and maybe too little concerned with art norms, maybe.
She has worn many hats and she
used to be the VIP hostess of Arsenal Football Club.
And
choreograph wedding dances to teach the first dance to people getting married.
Helle Siljeholm's artistic practice involves film, installation, choreography and performance.
I always have to try and understand a medium or a material from its initial point. I have this project where I try to interpret the mountain as a body on equal terms with our human bodies. That evolves around a series of choreographed sculptures in mountain hillsides. These moving sculptures or installations is also leaving behind the temporary pigment trace.
Back to the studio.
This work is a way to try to understand blockchain, maybe more as a philosophy and a possibility for a system of, well, togetherness.
Helle is the type of artist who's invested in building community and connections across cultures and perspectives. This commission project for Munch is also an example of this. A reflection on the interlinked and possible relationships between technology, ecology and the social. The wooden sticks found on the ground in different places in the world and sent in the post carry different narratives of exposed nature and personal stories. It is an attempt to make the invisible structure of blockchain visible and material. Blockchain as practice, as collective effort, and as a thought experiment with sticks.
Well, I ask people to send me sticks in the post. And I hope to gather as many sticks as possible. Vestegbergsgate 3A, 0177, Oslo.
If you asked her, the worst advice Helle ever received was
to put the prettiest picture of myself on the CV and walk up to a male choreographer.
The best compliment she got was
you could be the mayor of Beirut.
On a scale of 1 to 10 of Norwegianness, Helle would say she is a
maybe a 2? Well, what? Two was non-Norwegian? No, zero was non-Norwegian? Yeah, I think two.
Let's make it more difficult, but fun. Promise, it's fun. Now on to the Munch questionnaire. What pizza would Munch order?
I think he wouldn't have ordered pizza.
What would he eat?
I think he wouldn't eat that much. I think he would drink more, but maybe protein pills.
What's the first thing he does in the morning?
Drink.
What would Munch say about social media?
I think he would quite like social media, but maybe he would be one of those that pretends that he is off social media, so he has a secret account so he can follow the like on his official page.
If you met Munch, what would be the first thing you would say to him?
Probably well done.
How would you think Munch would do this questionnaire?
No, I think he would hate it.
This ends the Munch questionnaire!
I'm very happy to be commissioned for Munch, but it's also these processes which develops with sort of longer term relationships with curators that maybe also gives me the confidence that I think that this work should have a place there.
And so it should, Helle Siljeholm, so it should.